Hello to you from Mount Isa. We arrived yesterday, pretty much just drove right through to a free camp. It was the Irish Club free camp, just the other side of Mount Isa if you're coming from the east. Yeah, not bad. It's a I'll do some daytime footage there. But one thing you can't get away from, we've done some absolutely beautiful sights, some lovely towns, some wonderful entertainment, sunsets and sunrises. Hey, you get them all here as well, but there is one other side of the town, and of course that's what keeps the town alive. And we're looking at the Mount Isa copper mine here, and it's a huge industry. It's massive. It's a very big factory mine. Boom, town's just over here, and you've got this. So yeah, an amazing sight to see, and I'm sure we'll learn a little bit more about it as we drive around. We're just getting rid of you know what, and filling up with some water. So we're going to go and have a look at the town. I think there's a lookout. We can't get to the lookout with our van, but there's a few vans parked here just so they can get easy access into town and things. Yeah, that's Mount Isa for you. So there you have it, the view from the top. Mount Isa and its second largest copper mine in Australia, the town of Mount Isa in front of us, and I believe Mount Isa to be the rodeo capital of Australia. Now, probably the best vantage point you get to see the water tank with its paintings, its murals. There's a slightly better shot of the water tower. I mean, you can actually get the water tower from down on the road level there at some degrees, but it's nothing like being right up close to it. But you just can't see it for its full beauty.
Here we are walking into the Mount Isa Underground Hospital.
It's a good place to go to as well, the information centre in Mount Isa here.
Up found something new. These are actually not dodos, they're the demon duck of doom. They're actually ducks and they're meant to be 4 meters high. Was bought by a local man, Peter Kretcherman, I think it's pronounced, and it's a labour of love. Isn't it amazing, just the detail of it?
Oh well, sad days when you have to leave each destination. You do get attached to them, and you've had a good time. We are leaving Mount Isa. We've had a great time. We've discovered the lookout, and Jude had a fabulous time in the underground hospital, so that's a must see. It's very affordable and very knowledgeable. Just a quick thing that it was an underground hospital that was put in as a precaution if things got a little bit on the hairy side with an invasion from like the Darwin side of things. So yeah, it's some interesting history and things. She enjoyed that a lot. She did that. I didn't. I had to find a part for the van, which I was unsuccessful for with the water tank lock cap had disintegrated. So I'll hopefully in Darwin might be able to find one there to replace it. In the meantime, it's just got a foam bung stuck in there. And then we did a little bit of shopping around. We did the information center. That's a good place to go to as well. The information center in Mount Isa here. Some fabulous prehistoric creatures on the outside and on the inside. There's a great discovery tour to go and do. And next door to that, you can also get into the underground mine if you want to go and see an underground mine and all the workings. And the information center, very informative as well. There was a bloke there behind the counter. Top marks to you, mate. You did a fab job. So yeah, moving on, I've just got to hook the van up to the trailer. Today we are heading in the Tennant Creek direction, but we won't make it all the way there tonight. We will stop and have a little rest and then look at a park up place. Hopefully if we can get in at a park there where we can hook up some power and some water and do some chores and bits and pieces and have a decent hot long shower. So catch us soon further down the way. Thanks for following. Oh, and one thing more, I forgot to put in a credit for this Irish club park area. It mightn't look much behind me, it's just a bunch of gravel and of course with the smoke and stacks and behind you. Fortunately all the wind's been going in the right direction. A great spot and great locale. Okay, it's a little far if you've got a van like us and you might want to bike into town. It's not too far, it's only 2 or 3 k down the road. But there's a bottle shop over there, there's a dairy over there, and the Irish Club itself, fantastic place to go if you want to have a treat from cooking in the van. Real reasonably priced meals, good sized meals, tasty and great service. So the Irish Club, you'll find it on Wikicamps. It's highly recommended this time. So we've just traveled a couple of hours up the road. We're in Camooweal. There's a nice tribute here to the stockmen, drovers. And yeah, you've really noticed a big change in the country since we left Mount Isa there. A lot drier, a lot more rugged. And even the cattle. You know, they're looking like they're really having to work hard for their supper. So Camooweal, yeah, nice little town. There's a great drover's show that you can do down the road here. There's some caves nearby. There's the pub next door here. Service station, stretch the legs. And there's a nice Wikicamps free camp, which looked really nice on some of the photos, just the other side of the town here, across the bridge, looked really good. So, but we're going to keep going. We're going to go across the NT border, which is next, and onwards to our next Wikicamp stop.